What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading to Windows 11 23H2 using SCCM. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is load up our Microsoft Configuration Manager console. From here, we are going to click on Software. Within Software, we're going to get into Windows Servicing. We're going to click on All Windows Feature Updates. Now from here, we need to search for the following 23H2. You can either hit enter or click on the search button. I'm going to hit enter here. It's going to start processing and eventually return the two items that it will pick up. Now the one that we want will be the second one. We're going to right click on it. We're going to click on download, and you can either select the deployment package if you already have one. I don't have one, so I'm going to select the second option, and that's to create a new deployment package. Now we're going to give it a name, and you're going to provide a source location to drop the content into. So I provided the following. Pretty simple, right? We're going to click next here. We're going to click on add, and we're going to pick distribution point. We're going to select our DP. We're going to click OK. We're going to click next here. For the distribution priority, it's up to you. I'm going to click on the drop-down menu, and I'm going to select high, and I'm going to click next here. Now, for the download location, I left it as the default download software updates from the internet. We're going to click next. Left everything as a default, next here, a nice little summary, and we're going to click next here. Now, this process will take some time because there's a lot of content that's going to be pushed down into that UNC path that you provided. Now, if you go into that source file or that source location, you're going to see that one folder is going to be created. There's going to be two other ones, but if you want to check out the status of what's going on behind the scenes, there is a log file that's being created, and you can actually check it out. So if you right click on the start button and then click on run, you're going to type in the following %temp%, hit okay, and it's gonna take you to the temp folder, and you're going to locate the patch downloader.log file. We're going to select that log file. We're going to double click on it, and this is it. If you do not see any yellow or red, that means it's clean. It just takes a long, long time because there's about three folders that get, you know, downloaded into that source folder, and they're pretty big. Eventually, what's going to happen is you're going to get that green check mark. Everything was completed successfully. If you go back inside that folder where you drop the content, you're going to see three new folders, like I said before. If you go inside the properties of the root folder, you're going to see it is about 15 gigs. That's a lot of information that was pulled down from Microsoft to your local server. Now we're gonna close all this stuff up, and from here, we're gonna right click what we just downloaded, which would be the Windows feature. We're gonna right click on it, and we're going to click on deploy. Now for deploy, we're going to click on browse because we need to select our collection. Pick your collection. This is the collection that I'm going to pick. I'm going to click okay. We're going to click next here. Once you click on next, it wants you to accept the license and terms. So I'm going to click on accept license and terms and then click OK. And then it's up to you what type of deployment it is. If you click on the dropdown, you only have two options. Is it available or required? For this deployment, I made it available. I'm going to click next here. Pick your scheduling. I left everything as the default. Click next here. Pick how the user notification is going to be at the other end. If you click on the drop-down menu, you have two options. I picked the first option, which is display in software center and show all notifications. Once you do that, we're going to click next here. I left everything as the default, click next. Your download settings, this is up to you, but for the first option, I am going to switch it to download software updates from the distribution point and install. And then we're going to click next. You get a nice little summary. Click next here. Green check mark, which is a good thing. And we're going to close it. Now from here, if you go to assets and compliance and you click on device collection, I'm going to locate my collection, which is the Windows 11. I'm going to double click on it. And this is the, I only have one machine in my network, which is a Windows 11. We're going to actually go inside that machine. This is it right here. I'm going to right click on the start button. I'm going to click on Windows Terminal as an admin, and I'm going to type in hostname and hit enter, and VWindows 11 is the machine. Now we're going to close that up. We're going to click on the start menu. We're going to type in control or control panel. We're going to click on the control panel app. It's going to load this up. We're going to locate and click on configuration manager. It's going to take you here. We need to get into the actions tab. It's all up to you. It does take some time for it to be pushed out and published and notified on the machine that, you know, you have a new feature update. But if you want to push things along, what you could do is select software update deployment cycle, click on run now. You're able to click OK here. The next one will be the software update scan cycle. Click on run now. Click OK here. And the last one will be the machine policy retrieval cycle. Click run now and then click OK here. And again, it will take some time, but this is basically kickstarting the connection between the computer to your SCCM server so it can start pulling it down. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.